إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran many times, Musa alayhi salatu wa salam and his people, to learn the good things from these stories, and also not to repeat the mistakes that they did with Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, I mean Bani Israel. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Bani Israel from Fir'aun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala split the sea for them, and they could run and escape from Fir'aun. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Fir'aun to be drawn in the sea. They went toward the Ard al-Muqaddasah. As some scholars mentioned, it means Palestine, to the Masjid al-Aqsa. So many things happened during this period. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ يَا قَوْمِ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ جَعَلَ فِيكُمْ أَنْبِيَاءَ وَجَعَلَكُمْ مُلُوكًا وَآتَاكُمْ مَا لَمْ يُؤْتِ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ. They were going to fight some people. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam gave this introduction. And this is a reminder for them and for everyone. And mention, O Muhammad, when Musa alayhi salatu wasalam said to his people, O my people, remember the favor of Allah upon you when he appointed among you prophets. And this is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have only one prophet, Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, and he is enough for us and for the mankind and jinn also. Alayhi salatu wasalam. While he sent many prophets to Bani Israel, الرسل كانت تترى عليهم. When a prophet dies, there is another prophet. And also their leaders were prophets. And also this is a blessing. When your leader is a prophet, he will not be unjust. Always he will judge people according to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam reminded them, اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم. This is a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إذ جعل فيكم أنبياء. Prophets, it is not only one prophet. Then he said, وجعلكم ملوكا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you ملوكا as kings. But what is the meaning of that? Many scholars said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the freedom because you were slaves under Fir'aun. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved you from Fir'aun and now you are free people. Muluka. And there is a narration, one of the companions, so a tabi'i. So this tabi'i said, I have a wife and a house. Then he said, you are a rich person. He said, also I have a maid or a slave. He said, you are a king. So this is another concept of kingdom. When you are free, you have your house or your accommodation and you have your wife and a maid, you are a king. You are not a slave. وَجَعَلَكُمْ مُلُوكًا. Then he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَآتَاكُمْ مَا لَمْ يُؤْتِ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ. And gave you that which he had not given anyone among the worlds. So this is also a reminder for us. I mean the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah gave us the Quran, the best book. Allah sent to us the best messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by following this messenger, Nabi al-Ummi alayhi salatu wa salam. So this was introduction for something very important, which is the jihad. Musa said, يا قوم ادخلوا الأرض المقدسة التي كتب الله لكم ولا ترتدوا على أدباركم فتنقلبوا خاسرين. Oh my people, enter the blessed land which Allah has assigned to you. So this is a glad tidings for them from Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. This is for you. But you need to take an action. And this is very important, brothers and sisters, that we as Muslims, we need to work for our Islam. Not only to talk, you have to work for that. What kind of act that you did for your religion? Don't blame the others. Don't rely on others. You work for your religion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَّتِي كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. This is for you. So this is a glad tiding for them that you will win this battle. Allah will give you the victory, but you have to do something. وَلَا تَرْتَدُّوا عَلَىٰ أَدْبَارِكُمْ. And don't turn back from fighting to Allah in Allah's cause. فَتَنْقَلِبُوا خَاسِرِينَ. And thus become losers. You will lose both the dunya and the akhirah. You will lose dunya, you will not enter the blessed land. You will lose the akhirah because you commit a sin when you disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Immediately they said to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, قَالُوا يَا مُوسَىٰ إِنَّ فِيهَا قَوْمًا جَبَّارِينَ وَإِنَّا لَن نَدْخُلَهَا. They said, oh Musa, indeed, within it is tyrant people. They are causing mischief in the land, killing, stealing. Then they said, وَإِنَّا لَن نَدْخُلَهَا حَتَّى يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا. And indeed, we will not never enter it until they leave it. Subhanallah. How can they leave it and you are not doing anything? Lazy people, subhanallah. They should support Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. They should say, obey. They should say, we listen and obey, we are with you. But subhanallah, they went back and they left Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And they said something very bad. They said many things bad. Subhanallah. But of course, not all of them were bad people. No doubt, you know the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he saw in the dream, and this is a fact, many people will enter paradise. Then he said to Jibreel or to the angel, this is my nation. A big number of people, it was said to him, no, this is Musa and his followers alayhi salatu wasalam. So no doubt, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was followed by many believers, but also many of them, I mean his followers, disbelieved in Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, or they were weak believers. So among them, two righteous people, قَالَ رَجُلًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ يَخَافُونَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمَا. Said to men, two men from those who feared to disobey upon whom Allah had bestowed favor. They have good believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, good faith. They said, listen to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, obey Musa. And Musa alayhi salatu wasalam asked them to enter, udkhulu. If you notice here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, udkhulu. He did not say to fight. It was very easy, but subhanallah, as usual, Bani Israel, they like to make the things difficult. So these two believers said, udkhulu alayhim al-bab. فَإِذَا دَخَلْتُمُوهُ فَإِنَّكُمْ غَالِبُونَ. Enter, open them through the gate. For when you have entered it, you will be predominant. You will get the victory when you enter. How? This is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Nusirtu bil ru'b masirata shahr. Allah gave me the victory. Allah supported me. Bil ru'b. What is meaning ru'b? His enemy will get scared when they hear that Muhammad is coming to them by a distance 1 month, alayhi salatu wasalam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do that for the people of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, just to enter. Then they said the main thing in the whole story, I mean these two believers, وعلى الله فتوكلوا إن كنتم مؤمنين. And upon Allah rely if you should be believers. This is the main thing, brothers and sisters, to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be strong believers, to put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not on your power. أقول ما تسمعون الحمد لله. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده ما بعد. Again, the people of Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام, بنو إسرائيل, they repeated this bad statement and they made it worse. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said about them, قالوا يا موسى إنا لن ندخلها أبدا ما داموا فيها فاذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إنها هنا قاعدون. They said, oh Musa, subhanAllah, every time, oh Musa, he's the messenger of Allah. They did not say like the companions, Ya Rasulallah, alayhi salatu wasalam. When they called the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, they used to say, Ya Rasulallah, Ya Nabi Allah, but they used to call Musa by his name, Ya Musa, as one of their friends. No respect for their Prophet Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام. قالوا يا موسى إنا لن ندخلها. Indeed, we will not enter it ever as long as they are within it. So go, you and your Lord, and fight. Indeed, we are waiting here. Subhanallah. They did not support Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام. They were not silent. They were very bad in their statements. They told Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, number one, they call him with his name. And also, they did not respect our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said, you go with your Lord. He is also your Lord. He is Rabbul Alameen, the Lord of the whole universe. They said, you go with your Lord and you fight. Innaha huna qa'idun. We are waiting here. Subhanallah. Even they are not thinking to make dua for Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam knows that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with him. قال ربي إني لا أملك إلا نفسي وأخي فافرق بيننا وبين القوم الفاسقين. Harun was with him alayhi salatu wasalam, and of course always he is with him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Musa said, my Lord, indeed I don't possess except myself and my brother. So part us from the definitely disobedient people. They disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So make it far between us and them. I'm not one of them. They are not from me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed his punishment. And he said, قَالَ إِنَّهَا مُحَرَّمَةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ 40 سَنَةً يَتِيهُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَلَا تَأْسَ عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Allah made this victory very easy for them, but they refused. So what was the punishment? Allah said, then indeed, it is forbidden to them for 40 years in which they will wander throughout the land. So don't grieve over the disobedient people. Subhanallah. This is the punishment. It was very easy. You enter, you will get the victory. You will enjoy al-ard al-muqaddasa. But they refused. Allah punished them 40 years going around their place. The scholars said they cannot find the way to al-ard al-muqaddasa. They are going around themselves in Sahra Sina, in the desert there in Egypt. Going around, subhanallah. This was the punishment of disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is very important, brothers, to mention the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this great battle, which is called Yawm al-Furqan, to compare between the followers of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and their companions, the greatest people. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. المقداد ابن الأسود رضي الله تعالى عنه said, in the day of Badr, because it was very difficult, The number of Muslims, one third the number of the kuffar. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asking his companions. He was discussing the issue. It is a very sensitive issue. So Abu Bakr spoke, Umar spoke, radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't want them to speak. Why? Because he knows that they are with him. He's waiting the Ansar to give him the permission or to give him the green light to fight. Because the bay'ah, it was, the bridge was to defend the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina. But now we are outside the Medina. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't know if they will fight with him or not. So al-Muqdad radiyallahu ta'ala an said, inna la naqulu lak kama qalat banu Israel li Musa, idhhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila inna hahuna qa'idun walakin amdi wa nahnu ma'ak. Muqdad said, we will not say like the children of Israel what they said to Musa, go you and your Lord and fight, you two, we are sitting here, but we say proceed and we are with you. Subhanallah, this is the greatest generation. I mean the generation of the companions radiallahu ta'ala. I mean people wonder why we speak a lot about the companions, why should we respect the companions, why should we follow and love the companions, because of this situation and many situations during the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They gave everything to support Islam and the Prophet of Islam Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. جعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. اللهم نجي إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم احفظ إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين وانصرهم على أعدائهم. اللهم حرم المسجد الأقصى من أيدي يهود واجعل صلاة المسلمين فيه صلاة آمنة مطمئنة متقبلة يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا واشفي مرضانا وعافي مبتلانا ونجح طلابنا واحفظ الشباب والبنات من السوء والفحشاء يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.